everyone. I'm Joyce Tseng with the latest news from here in Taipei. Taiwan's vice president-elect, Bi Kim-shiao, was reportedly stalked by a Chinese official during her visit to the Czech Republic last month. Czech media said local police intercepted a car from the Chinese embassy that was tailing Xiao's motorcade after she arrived in Prague. Police said the Chinese military attaché driving the car ran a red light and almost caused an accident before being stopped. Taiwan's foreign ministry asked the Czech government to verify the claims. Analysts say China's actions would be a serious breach of Czech democracy if proven true.
它基本上是对捷克的自由民主的一个政治体制的一种挑战。这样的一个跟踪的方式，其实在一个民主国家，这很明显是不违法的。更何况，今天肖副总统他是好等于说是捷克的参议院议长所邀请的一个重要的一个人物。
Another body has been found in the search for survivors of Wednesday's earthquake in Hualien, bringing the total number of fatalities to 13. Rescuers identified the remains of a 21-year-old woman who was hiking alone in Taroko National Park, where there were heavy rockfalls. The bodies of a father and daughter were found nearby in earlier searches, with three other members of the family still missing. Six people remain unaccounted for as search and rescue efforts pass the 72-hour golden window for finding survivors. People in Taiwan are still reckoning with the aftermath of Wednesday's deadly earthquake. Hundreds of buildings across the country have been affected, and authorities are working quickly to prevent any further damage.
Tearing down the leaning 10-story building that's become a symbol of the deadly earthquake that struck Taiwan on Wednesday. Authorities say it will take 2 weeks to demolish the structure, which was built in the 80s. It survived damage from quakes before, but now on the verge of collapse, it's coming down for good.
我觉得就是来到现场之后才会发现，哇，人类真的非常的渺小，就是因为一场天灾之后，然后它的这栋楼也快50年了，所以它的使命也到达了。This
building shows the worst of the latest quake's impact on structures. Unlike in 1999, when the last deadly quake of a similar magnitude hit Taiwan, irreversibly damaging 10,000 buildings. But still, many people across Taiwan are not in the clear. Here in the capital, over 100 kilometers away from the epicenter of the quake, crumbling ceilings have forced residents out of homes. The latest stats from Wednesday's quake show that 430 buildings across Taiwan require damage assessments. 18 have been tagged red, meaning the main structures are damaged, and 34 have been tagged yellow, meaning non-essential structures like indoor partitions and ceilings are compromised.
如果是红灯或是黄灯，它的后续都可以补强或修理，民众可以任选。In Hualien,
some residents are being allowed back inside their homes, but only for 30 minutes to retrieve their valuables.
就是文件啊，一些随身的一些衣物啊。还有机会再上去吗？没有，他现在不能再上去。
With people unable to go home and hundreds still trapped in Taroko National Park, cut off from the only road out. Though Taiwan has largely contained the impact of this quake, full recovery is still a ways away.
The demolition of that partially collapsed building in Hualien has been suspended after aftershocks continue to shake Taiwan. Authorities at the site say more tools are needed to continue the work safely. This is just the second day of demolition in a process that's already expected to take weeks.
不断的因为大小余震的变动，让这个结构体不断的位移。如果去强化安全，其实最大的困难就是地震余震不断，本来是以人为的观测。
Humanitarian aid may decrease for the 2 million Palestinians facing war and starvation in Gaza after an Israeli airstrike killed 7 aid workers, Tiffany Wong reports.
A ship meant to bring aid to Palestinians with nowhere to go. One Spanish NGO says it's suspending humanitarian operations in Gaza. The NGO was working in conjunction with World Central Kitchen to provide food for Palestinians when seven of their colleagues were killed in an Israeli airstrike on Monday.
Estamos todos muy afectados, es triste, es indignante. Nos hacemos una idea de lo que está sucediendo en Gaza, de lo que está sufriendo la población en Gaza desde hace meses y toda nuestra voz y todos nuestros altavoces para denunciar lo que está ocurriendo aquí, porque esto tiene que detenerse ya.
It's been almost half a year since war between Israel and Hamas broke out, and millions of Palestinians are experiencing extreme hunger in the besieged Gaza Strip. Humanitarian aid into Gaza is controlled by Israel, and NGOs are calling on the UN Security Council to demand accountability for the obstructions to aid and the killings of aid workers.
If we continue down this path, then the next set of mass deaths of children in Gaza will not be from bullets and bombs. It will be from starvation and malnutrition.
Israel has taken responsibility for the airstrikes and says its investigation found serious procedural errors and violations in the lead-up to the attack. But the UN Secretary General has called for an independent investigation into the killings.
But the essential problem is not who made the mistakes. It is the military strategy and procedures in place that allow for those mistakes to multiply time and time again.
The UN Human Rights Council adopted a resolution to halt arms sales to Israel, adding pressure to condemn violations of international humanitarian law. But the resolution is not binding, and for the 2.3 million Palestinians who rely on humanitarian aid, a possible halt in arms sales does little to counter the immediate threat of starvation. Patrick Chen and Tiffany Wong for Taiwan Plus.
More than a million people are expected to join Taiwan's largest religious celebration, the Dajia Mazu pilgrimage. As Jaime Ocon explains, this year will focus on praying for a speedy recovery from the recent earthquake.
At 11 o'clock Friday night, Taiwan's largest religious procession, the Dajia Mazu pilgrimage, set out. More than 200 people gathered in Taizong in central Taiwan to see the sea goddess Mazu leave her temple. Although Taiwan is still recovering from a magnitude 7.2 earthquake, temple officials here are urging people to join their march, especially as this year's pilgrimage straddles a holiday weekend. The Dajia Mazu pilgrimage is Taiwan's largest religious event. Over a million people will take part in this nine-day cavalcade. An effigy of the sea goddess Mazu is carried over 340 kilometers as she visits more than 100 temples between Taizong and Jiayi. Many pilgrims escorting Mazu's palanquin will get down on their hands and knees as she passes above them, hoping for good fortune. This year, officials say many are praying for Taiwan's speedy recovery from the quake. They hope that the sea goddess will bring a little extra help to those affected. Along the way, pilgrims will celebrate Mazu's birthday on April 9th. During the celebrations, they'll be wishing both Mazu and those affected by the quake all the best. Patrick Chen and Jaime Ocon for Taiwan Plus.
The Hakka lion dance is declining in Taiwan, with fewer and fewer practitioners. But one of the art form's last masters is keeping it alive with new ideas. Sandy Chi has this story.
With focus and patience, Master Liu Wenzhen is adding new layers to an old cultural tradition. He is working on the centerpiece of the Hakka lion dance. Hakka lion dance is a martial and performance art that originated in China. It was brought to Taiwan centuries ago by the Hakka people. but it's slowly fading as other kinds of entertainment compete for attention. That's why Liu, one of the last masters of Hakka lion dance, is adding in new elements to keep up with current trends.
客家诗是在于我们的好几千年的历史啊，好，说现在因为时代的潮流哈，你就让它失传掉、消灭掉，有没有？我们感觉到非常的可惜啦。
76-year-old Liu has dedicated 45 years of his time and energy to the Hakka lion dance in Taoyuan, northern Taiwan. Throughout his life, he's come up with ways to keep the art form in the public eye.
你的客家诗现在我不发扬下去，将来也会被社会淘汰掉啊！没有创新就没有进步啊！Traditionally,
the lion heads only came in two colors, yellow and green. But thanks to Liu's innovation, they now feature many different colors and patterns.
我们客家人叫做五代同堂啊，哈，五代同堂啊，就是把五种颜色，哈，比较花俏，这表演出来看起来就比较华丽。所以我现在制作的丝绸的彩绘呢，哈，我也有黄丝，哈，也有橘的，啊，也有红的，也有黑丝，也有蓝丝。Liu
is not just changing up the colors; he also produces Hakka lion heads in different sizes, using materials that are both lighter and easier to find.
我用水搅拌，用纱布，一层纱布，一层纸，一层纱布，比较不容易裂掉，而且那做起来又比较轻。Performers
of all ages can use the small and lighter lion heads, and they can also perform the new dances Liu choreographed.
所以我训练就把那个客家的国歌，把拿着丝轴配合那音乐来跳这个舞。 好，所以叫创意客家诗，那是我又开发一个新的出来，新的产品，新的表演的项目之一。But
making a small Hakka lion head is almost as difficult as making a big one. It requires a lot of patience and attention to detail, and can take up to 1 month.
所以说，要很细心哦，不能大意哦。Building
up the basic layers, shaping the rectangular jaw. Painting and adding patterns all requires a very steady hand.
这个就是葫芦啊，这个就铜花，这个就先天的那八卦。Throughout
his career, Liu has crafted hundreds of Hakka lion heads in all sorts of colors and sizes. With his innovative ideas and a deep passion for the craft, Liu hopes the art form will flourish in Taiwan. He also hopes to share his innovations and enthusiasm in China, fostering a cross-strait cultural exchange and ensuring the survival of this traditional art. Kama Shu, Klang Wong and Sani Chi for Taiwan Plus.
Scientists are getting to know a little more about the life cycle of pufferfish after researchers successfully bred them for the first time in Taiwan. Maddie Anstruther has more.
This pair of baby long-spined porcupine fish are the newest arrivals at a marine museum in Taiwan, the result of the country's first successful attempt to breed them artificially. While the longspine is the most common type of pufferfish in northern Taiwan, its offspring have remained somewhat of a mystery to researchers. That is, until now.
从来没看过它的那个小的个体，那我们看到当它进到家去的话，通常它的体型就已经比较大了，那这次就是很难得，我们刚好有机会记录到收集到它的受精卵，然后从孵化的
Now the museum can observe the baby pufferfish. They're learning all sorts of surprising things.
原本以为就是这些河豚，它们应该是很贪吃，因为长大的河豚都非常非常的贪吃，什么都吃。那在饲养的过程中，竟然就发现这些小宝宝，它们非常非常的挑食。Out
of the 2,000 eggs the researchers began with, only 20 hatched, and the two strongest specimens are on show to the public. And although they may look harmless at first, the pair seem to enjoy showing off their strength every once in a while. The fish can swell to twice or three times their original size, causing their spikes to stick out and scaring off potential predators. The fish began to develop this impressive ability at just 14 days old, making even these babies a force not to be puffed at. Ryan Wu and Maddie Anstruther for Taiwan Plus.
Thank you for watching What's Up Taiwan. I'm Joyce Tseng. Take care and see you next time.